All right, so now that you've seen that paddlefish have no teeth and don't eat anything major, the way you catch them is snagging. So I'm going to show you how to set up a fishing pole to get ready to snag for them. So first you just put a sinker on the very bottom, and I'm just tying this directly to my line, but if you are in an area with a lot of rocks or sticks, you want to put a lighter weight line and a swivel so that if your sinker snags up, you can break that part off without losing a whole bunch of your line. And then you fish with great big treble hooks. At this point, they've actually set the law so they're smaller than they used to be. So this is a number 8-aught treble hook. If you just make a loop out of your line, run it through the eye, run the entire hook through, and slip it on, it's tied onto your line. And then what you do is you take your tag end, which goes down to your sinker, put it up through the little notches in the part of the treble hook as you wrap it around, go up, start wrapping, and then come down. And what that does is it holds it level with your line. As you can see, I have a fairly heavy duty pole. Most people fish with about a 9 to 10 foot fishing pole, because as you'll see when I'm casting, you want to be able to make big sweeps to snag the fish, because you don't know where they are. So you want to try and cover as much of the water as possible with your hooks. So now that we have the setup, I'm going to go show you how to cast.
Go.
All right, so as you see, great big sweeps with the pole. You want to cover as much water as possible. By the time you're using a 3 to 5 ounce weight, depending on how fast the water's moving, you don't stand and do it for hours and hours on end. You do about a dozen casts, and then usually you trade off with people, because if they're really running, a lot of people down there. So I hope you found this informative, and enjoy the pictures of the paddlefish I have caught. Thank you.